So we're heading to the Farm Institute in Katama. As Claire does when she's shopping for the dinner she's going to prepare for the Hermit of Chappaquiddick for the first time. Now, she comes here to buy a true farm-raised chicken, because if Claire's going to roast a chicken, it has to be the ultimate chicken. It has to be a natural, farm-raised, pastured chicken. So in one of the chapters of Island Apart, it's a chapter actually called Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, my protagonist Claire Doheny goes on a shopping trip to buy the provisions for dinner that she's going to prepare for the Hermit. And one of the stops is the Farm Institute, where she buys a chicken. So by way of background, tell us a little bit about the Farm Institute, how you got started, what your mission is, what you actually do.
My name is John Previant, and I'm the executive director of the Farm Institute, located here on the Katama Plains on the island of Martha's Vineyard. The Farm Institute is going on 13 years old. This is the sixth year at this location, and we are a full tilt teaching and working farm. We focus our efforts on engaging children and adults in the practice and results of sustainable agriculture. And to that point, we raise a lot of animals ourselves here on the farm. And we also actually are one of the only licensed facilities on the island for processing chickens for sale. Mm-hmm. So when we raise chickens here, and we raise a specific breed that is not a commercially popular breed, it's more of a breed that's specific for pasturing. We raise them here in batches of about 100, and when they reach the right weight, we actually process and slaughter them here on our own facility and offer them for sale either within a few days as fresh or as frozen throughout the year.
Okay, and tell me, what is the name of the breed of chicken?
It is variously known as kosher kings, but that has nothing to do with being kosher, because sure, they're not, or colored rangers or silver barred rangers. Different parts of the country refer to them in different ways.
And what do you like about that particular breed?
It's not the commercial Cornish Rock Cross. It's a breed that likes to be outdoors, wants to forage, wants to get out and scratch and peck, and is much better suited for pasture raising.
Yeah, and you mentioned this pasturing a couple mm-hmm. times. Describe for us what that is, for us city folk who
sure.
sort of are used to chickens that come in a cold case.
We get our chickens at a day old from different hatcheries, or sometimes from one specific place. And we keep them inside in a brooder room for a few days, and then we move them to another brooder room. We kind of get them acclimated to their environment. One-day-old chicks need a very, very warm temperature, and we provide that in kind of an enclosed space where they have plenty of room to move around, but we can keep it over 90 degrees. When they're ready to go outside, they live in what we call chicken tractors, which are small portable housing units that have access to the area immediately in front of the unit so that they can scratch and peck to their heart's content. And then that unit gets moved either every day or every other day, depending upon the weather and how aggressive they've been with their scratching and pecking. While they're out there, we continue to supply them with additional feed as well as water.
So these are chickens that are actually walking around outside.
Right, and it gives the meat a completely different flavor, and it since it's a different shape bird actually than the conventional birds, and the exercise they get, you get a completely different tasting and looking product. I mean, it doesn't look deformed or weird, it's just not your conventional big-breasted chicken. It looks more like a real bird.
Right, so a more natural looking bird, such as one might have found 100 years ago.
Absolutely, and that's why we're fond of them.
Uh-huh. And this business of moving the house, because mm-hmm. I've heard that from a lot of farmers here, why do you do that?
Well, they eat all the bugs in one area, and so they need to be moved. Number two, you don't want them spending any more time in their own manure.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.